Hi guys, another video from the Lambo. I'm driving here in Germany on the Autobahn towards Hub Berlin. I'm gonna meet Tony, the founder and lead developer of Abiteball. I'm very excited to meet him for the first time. And since it's raining here, I can't speed. So yeah, that sucks. But I can make a video. So it's been a long time that I made a video talking about my portfolio. The last time was when I was in Thailand on the beach there, and I shared that I had been, well, Bitcoin was going up, alts were going down, and that I was buying Bitcoin Cash and Biteball. And also that I was planning to more apply the strategy to, as Roger Ver has done over his, when he entered cryptocurrency, to buy and hold. And I really like that as strategy, so I've applied this to Bitcoin Cash and Biteball. Since I've been buying this the past few months, and Bitcoin Cash went up a lot in the meantime. It was then around 0.08 Bitcoin, and now it's at 0.2 Bitcoin, but it has gone to 0.5 Bitcoin in the meantime, very shortly, and then it corrected, and now it's about 0.2. So that's, I'm very happy with, I'm planning to really keep this position, not trade it, as I have done in the past with Bitcoin, trying to sell on a high, buy on a low, but overall you just lose Bitcoins with that, because you're always wrong in estimating how high it will go, and so you sell too soon, you can never buy these Bitcoins back. I don't want to do that again with Bitcoin Cash, so I'm just going to hold this and not trade this. And that's what I'm saying now. We will see, because of course always have to be open for changing your mind, and I am of course also willing to change my mind if people go crazy. I will change my mind. Let's say Bitcoin Cash goes up to equal valuation as Bitcoin, Bitcoin for one Bitcoin Cash in let's say 1 or 2 months time. Yeah, that's way too soon. That's not gonna hold. I do believe Bitcoin Cash in the long term will become more valuable than Bitcoin, but it's gonna take probably a couple of years. So if it's too soon, then of course it's very likely overvalued, and then of course I might break my rule and do sell some, but only when the market is doing extreme stuff. Otherwise I just stay put. So the same for my Biteball position, Bites and Black Bites, that has not gone up versus Bitcoin yet. It's still at 0.03 per gigabyte, so per GB. So I think that's still an interesting buy. And also Black Bites, that has been going up. Black Bites, it used to be 0.03 also, but then white gigabyte per black gigabyte, but now that's 0.05, so that's been going up, but it's still ridiculously valued at 10 million or so. It's really low, so I think even though it has gone up the past month, still a very, very interesting buy, Black Bites. And you can buy Black Bites only with White Bites. It's not quoted on any exchange. You can only buy it via the Biteball wallet on some decentralized exchanges like Freeb, free.be. So I will put that link again in my description of the video if you're interested. But I think you should certainly check out my previous video I made yesterday, 2 days ago. I kept it short. but I think it's very interesting to judge whether we're in an overvalued territory, whether we will correct it. It's now 290 billion, and I haven't checked today, maybe it's already 300 billion. Bitcoin is close to $10,000, $9,500, I think. So, what will happen? Well, I personally think the odds are the highest that this will boom, continue to go up a lot. It will overshoot. Bitcoin will breach 10,000, I think. We'll go to higher, 12, 13. But in the meantime, altcoins will go absolutely crazy, I think. Ethereum, the leaders are starting to go up a lot. Bitcoin Cash, Dash, Monero, everything is pumping now from the top coins. But I think the mid-cap coins are going to start pumping a lot too. The top 50, and that's why I think Bybit is still a very good investment right now. The bytes haven't really gone up yet versus Bitcoin, but I think this can pump very hard like so many others. So I personally think the next 2 months we go to $1 trillion market cap. We just have started an acceleration. If you look at my previous video, we went sideways a little bit the past 3 months, from 120 billion to 240 billion, but it took 3-4 months. That's a slow rise in cryptocurrency. It's not a parabolic rise, it's almost a sideways movement. You can see that the first 3 months of the year, the market cap went up parabolically, but then it went up sideways, and now I think it started again going up parabolically. So I think that the momentum is there to go from the current 280 to 1 trillion. That's only times 4, and that can be achieved in 1 to 1 month's time, 1 to 2 months' time, and it will be a mania. And most of these the altcoins will go up a lot more than Bitcoin again. But it's now the mid caps and the small caps are next. First the mid caps now, and after that the small caps too. So mid caps is top 50, small caps is top 1,000. And at the final end, even the shit coins will go crazy. So I think that this has the highest odds to happen right now, the next month. But if it happens, I think it's going to be the best selling opportunity available over the past few years, and for the next year to 2 years too. So if it happens, I plan to go to a minority of crypto again, and then I will break my rule and sell Bitcoin Cash and sell Bybit. But only if it goes ballistic, if it goes crazy, if it is clearly overvalued in the short term. So what can happen for Bybit? For Bytes, it's now 0.03 BTC per gigabyte, but it has quoted 10 times higher 3-4 months back. It was 0.3 BTC per GB. So I think we can go back to that. In this kind of bubble, we can see that. It goes times 10 in Bitcoin value while Bitcoin continues to go up. And so right now, that means it's about $250 or so per gigabyte. Well, times 10 and then plus 50%. So we're talking, well, the previous peak was about $1,000 per gigabyte. Well, we can go to $3,000 from the current $250 in a very short time frame. And the same is true for many, many other altcoins. So, and of course, at that point, these are, of course, selling opportunities, not buying opportunities. But right now, yeah, I think it's still a buying opportunity. But I continue to apply the same strategy as I have been applying since the start of this year, since the end of last year, that I don't hold Bitcoin. I hold, sometimes I hold Bitcoin shortly, but right now I'm out of Bitcoin again. I prefer, well, to have some fiat and some altcoins than to have Bitcoin. And so if you give me a stash of Bitcoins, I will automatically split it up in a piece altcoins and a piece fiat. I find that better for me, it's more interesting because I only want to invest in things I believe in that have strong fundamentals. Because otherwise, when there is a correction, I will not be able to hold it and I will just panic sell it. I will not believe in it. I will not continue to believe in it because the fundamentals are not strong for me. And that's a problem for me with Bitcoin. The transaction fees are still very high. $5 per transaction. And so I don't believe this is, it will grow. It can grow in value, but in real utility it can grow too, because many people don't care about that $5. There are a lot of use cases where Bitcoin is still very useful, even if it costs $5 per transaction, but much of the growth will just go to other coins that are not $5 per transaction. And that's, there are so many, and that's so easy to accomplish. So that's why I can't hold Bitcoin. Actually, I have held Bitcoin the past 3 months. I did scale up when I had 10-20% Bitcoin position the past 3 months, but I sold it all. Actually the past few weeks. Actually, there was only 10% position, but I've been selling before too. But 10% of my portfolio was Bitcoin, it's now fiat. So I used to be, I did a few big moves. My last scaling out was 3-4 months back when I went to basically 80% fiat and only 20% crypto. And I started actually 2-3 years ago, well, many years before, let's not talk about that, but starting at the bottom in 2015, in January 2015, I decided to go 80% crypto and only 20% fiat. And I've been scaling out of that, starting at in this year, especially since March, when the first altcoin boom had happened. You remember the video when I was on my tropical island there celebrating altcoins? That's when I really started to scale down my crypto for fiat from 80%, starting down to 60%, 50%, and then down to even only 20% crypto and 80% fiat. So that was a huge scaling out and I overdid it. But what I did was, basically I was in alts for the most part and I sold it for fiat. And so, a month back, a month and a half back, I started to turn this around. First from, it was about 25% fiat I had, and then only 25% crypto and 75% fiat. I scaled it back to, I went back into crypto I went first to 50% crypto, and from only 25% to 50% crypto, and quickly to 60% crypto. And then the market has gone up, and so that 60% crypto went to about 80% crypto exposure in my portfolio because it went up. And I'm very happy with that, of course. I have new all-time highs in my portfolio finally. Because I only made money till the first 3-4 months of the year, and then because I had scaled out so much, I wasn't making, well, and there was also a correction, I wasn't losing much money, but then it picked up again, I wasn't making much money neither, And so, and that was for the case for 3 months or so during the summer. And then I scaled back in, and our market went up. So I'm at new all-time highs, and I'm very, very happy with that. It's unbelievable how fortunate we are in this market. But of course, it's not just being fortunate. You also have to do it. You have to make those investment decisions and dare to risk it. And I'm very proud of myself that I've continued to do that. So, but now, basically in fiat, I went up a lot this year until the middle of the year, and then took a break, and now I went up a lot again. And so that's why I decided to scale out again now, from 80% crypto to about 60% crypto again, or 70%, something like that, 65. And so 15% crypto I converted into fiat. And my plan with this fiat is to invest in a gold and gold mining portfolio, resources, precious metals, commodities, because if you look at the cycles, the commodity cycle chart, I will link it also in the description of the video. We're at the low again. The price of commodities versus versus stocks is at an all-time low again. And these cycles are about every 20 years or so. And so I do think that the odds are becoming quite high that we're gonna see a correction in the stock market. And I think the cryptocurrency community is really, for the most part, wrong in thinking that crypto will go up during a stock market correction. This is not the case. It will go down. Crypto will correct also strongly. This is perceived as a high-risk investment in the broad market. And so when stocks go down, people will also stop investing in cryptos, and people will also sell cryptos together with stocks. They will even sell gold. So everything gets sold during a recession, especially high-risk investments. So actually I have time with my cash, it's like 30% of my portfolio, so there's no rush to invest this, but it is reserved for a gold and a commodity portfolio, a resource company portfolio. That's my plan with that. I think that's a very good diversification. I've thought about many possible diversifications for me because I could do real estate. I don't own any real estate. I've been thinking about that, but I decided against it. Or I did some research in land and in developing countries like Kenya and Mauritius. It's all interesting, but requires a lot of work, and if I do that gold portfolio, I'm just gonna follow someone else. I'm not gonna have to bother with that myself. But I can easily follow someone else. I would follow Roland Van Damme, his portfolio, who has proven to have on average 20% per year return over the next the past 15 years that were his returns, and I think that's excellent in the world of traditional investing. That's an excellent return. And so this is my nest egg in case crypto fails, or of course in case crypto corrects strongly, then of course I will take some money out of that portfolio too if I see really, really big opportunities in crypto. But right now it's clearly in a bubble, crypto, so it's not certainly not the time to do that. So yeah, that's a little bit my story about my portfolio. Lambo still driving really well. As you can hear. real treat, but that's for another video. So is there something else I can say about investing? Something interesting, like right now, should you invest in the crypto market? Because something said as a comment on my video, hey, thanks to your video, I decided to go all in. And for me, it's like, whoa. If you start with investing right now in crypto, I don't think it's a good idea to copy my allocation, like, or to go all in. Like, I am now like 60-65% in crypto. Is it a good idea to copy that? Well, I personally think not if you're starting, because for me, I am sitting on a lot of profits. So if the market corrects you strongly, then I'm gonna feel the pain, but I'm still gonna be in very nice profits looking back on this year. Even if I lose half my portfolio, I'm still sitting on nice, very good profits. So, but that's not the case if you're just starting out. If you lose half your portfolio, it's likely that's hard-earned money, or money that took you many, many, many years to build up via traditional investment. So if you just invested and then in half a year you lose half of that money, that's very, very difficult. Yeah, I mean, and if you don't have the stomach for that, then you're gonna do stupid stuff and sell at the bottom, because it could be much more than half. Crypto can correct 90%, and so let's say you do like 80% in crypto and only 20% fiat. 80% minus 90%, that means only 8% left. So basically your portfolio, and you're gonna probably buy some more on the way down, so basically your portfolio will be decimated. So if you can stand such volatility, then yes, you could just copy what many of these good crypto investors do right now, who have a very large exposure still today. You can do that, but I don't think it's a good idea. You should take it, like right now, only invest a small part and wait for corrections to invest a bigger part, and wait for a big correction to invest half, and wait for a very big correction before you're gonna decide to allocate a very big piece of your portfolio, the majority of your portfolio. And this can take indeed years, like can take 2 years before such opportunity arises. But I think it's the best idea. Right now, small corrections are a very high probability. Hey, it just went up a lot, everything. So there's a good chance it corrects from, what is it now, 280 or 300 billion. Well, the probability that we're seeing 200 billion over the next few weeks is certainly there. A 50-50, I would say. So that means that you can basically buy at 50% discount with some patience. Of course, it can also go indeed straight to 1 trillion from here, or first to 500 billion and then correct to 300 billion and then to 700 billion. And of course, then you couldn't buy at 200 billion anymore. So that's why you do invest a small part already, let's say 25% of your portfolio, or 20%, just in case. So that's how you need to do that. Well, I hope that's helpful. Thanks all for watching, guys. And if anyone is in Berlin, please, I'll be here in Berlin till Wednesday. If you like to meet up, Hub Berlin, the festival is quite expensive. But if you want to meet up the next day, Wednesday, I'm happy to do that. Please add me on your Telegram. That's @MarkDeMezel. and then you can send me personal messages and we can call and we can meet up. Thanks so much all for watching, and see you later. Bye bye.